Chandos Investments. Welcome to Kingsgate.
Thank you very much.
Fantastic. I'm so excited to have you here. We've been trying to get you here for a while, so welcome.
Yeah, today.
Absolutely, that's all that matters.
Yeah.
Michael, obviously you've had a very long career. Could you just maybe give us a bit of your background and a bit of history into how you got here as a director of one of the largest developments in KZN?
Thanks, Patrick. Yeah, basically we started as a project management company, PM Solutions. We've been trading for about 18 years. Core business being project management, quantity surveying, and really providing services to your third big corporates in the property sector, your Growth Points, your Redefine, your Liberties. And basically we've obviously expanded to a more owning our own developments and doing our own developments. And that's really has been a good starting point for us. And where we are now, and obviously Kingsgate's been one of our prime projects and been our catalyst project, and obviously we want to roll out more Kingsgates. So we're really excited with the venture, and property is the way to go, and for me, I'm so excited to be in the space. So I think from a growth point of view, being a developer is quite key for us, and obviously to play in the space and take part in the mainstream economy.
Very, very much so. Can I just follow on? You said Kingsgate is due to be almost a national product. And obviously you're going to run it out into various different locations around the country. Can you just share your vision on how you see that happening and what sort of areas you potentially may go into?
Obviously with the success that we've had at, in KZN, in particular Hillcrest, we've had a lot of inquiries of bringing the product because of the being a very good upmarket product with a very, very good affordable price range. We've obviously got inquiries in the Eastern Cape, Northern KZN, right? A lot of the big towns in Richards Bay, you know, and obviously Gauteng. So for us, there's a lot of opportunities for us to take the brand and grow the brand to broader areas, and obviously to take advantage of the opportunities that present themselves, especially in this climate where the economy is not doing so well, but we are selling units, so it shows that there's a need and there's a market for the products.
Absolutely.
So we're excited with that opportunity.
Yeah, and I suppose that goes into my next question. Affordable housing is such a hot topic, or maybe the lack of affordable housing is such a hot topic in South Africa at the moment. And Kingsgate really provides a solution for that. What do you think is a long-term solution for our country in terms of affordable housing, Michael?
Patrick, I think for us, and obviously my personal view, affordability doesn't mean substandard, doesn't mean poor quality. Mm. For us, affordability is the right product at the right location.
Yes.
And obviously it's about economics of it, in terms of making sure that it's the, you know, you get something that people will appreciate, people would love and enjoy.
Yeah. Yeah.
And for us, obviously the affordability factor is not about providing substandard.
Yes.
And that's what we've proven on Kingsgate.
Yeah,
we provided a product that is upmarket, a product that is affluent, a product that, you know, brings the society together in terms of social cohesion.
Yeah.
You know, and obviously what it does is that it helps in the whole process of making sure that people can still afford to live in a bigger and a better suburb.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Patrick, take for example, I'm from Umlazi. Yeah. And the going rate of those houses that were built in the apartheid days are ranging between 600,000 to 800,000.
Wow.
If you go and buy a house in the township, that's what you spend now.
Yeah.
We give it an entry level of 600,000 at the same price.
Absolutely.
You know, that tells you, it's not about affordability in the price range.
Yes.
It's about affordability in terms of the product that you're providing.
Yeah, I couldn't agree with you more. And I think one of the most pleasing things for us is the diverse demographic of people that we've actually seen come to the site and actually buy here. I mean, literally we've had people buy of all colors, of all races, of all different walks of life. Michael, you've given us a brief history of your career. Could you maybe just mention a few of the projects that you have been actually involved in over the past?
We've been excited by obviously getting involved in quite prestigious projects in KZN, in particular in Durban. We use a phrase in our office, we punch above our weight, and that's proven by the project that we're doing at the moment. I mean, we started projects like the ICC Durban, more on the project management side,
yes.
to projects like Freedom Park in Pretoria, okay, which was a presidential project.
Yeah.
You talk about Oyster Box Hotel, which is one of the few seven-star hotels in KZN.
Yes.
To projects like Oceans and Climate that we involved with today. So I must say, from a size point of view, we really do punch above our weight, and obviously clients come to us, you know, because of the value and the service that we provide.
Yes, very, very much so. We mentioned, Michael, the affordability of the Kingsgate scheme, and also offering the quality of what you would associate with much more expensive developments. And, you know, Kingsgate has a slogan, live, work, play. And I really think we encapsulate that. How have you actually managed to achieve the prices? Because we started out at $599,000 for a beautiful apartment in an estate that offers all your recreational facilities, your securities, and commercial opportunities as well. How have you as developers managed to keep it so affordable?
Patrick, I think the secret to this is a simple one. Mark and I, who are partners, we're partners in the development, have our own internal project management, our own internal quantity surveying, and our own internal construction business.
Okay.
So for us, it made sense that we use our own businesses.
Yeah,
and in that way, we obviously cut the middleman.
Okay.
Because then we were able to make sure that we achieve the prices, you know, that are affordable, okay, but also providing something good for the market.
Absolutely, good quality.
So for us, I think that is really the key to it. And obviously, it also minimizes the risk on our side by having, you know, having done things done internally.
Yeah.
So that's really how we've actually encapsulated. And that's really our secret to it.
No, 100%. And I think your secret's actually got onto the sales side, because I think we've done over 220 sales in Kingsgate to date. And I mean, we have waiting lists of people wanting, you know, our apartments. So I think people really have actually bought into the fact that it's affordable, but it's still a quality development.
Absolutely, absolutely. So I think for us, obviously, you know, over and above the price and over and above the affordability, you get that social cohesion.
Very much.
You know, you get the demographics. Your earlier question talks about the different demographics.
Yep.
And that's really what we're trying to achieve.
Absolutely.
We've really achieved it.
Yeah.
You know, so for us, that's key. You know, people doesn't think affordability is cheap.
No, 100%. And it's almost, you know, Desmond Tutu, I've seen coined the phrase, the rainbow nation. But I mean, we've actually achieved it in Kingsgate, because we really have had people from all walks of life purchasing, which is fantastic. Marco, you mentioned how you keep the price so affordable by using your construction teams and your construction company and other services. But obviously, in South Africa, skills development, job creation, upliftment of community, local communities is absolutely vital. Could we just touch on that?
Patrick, I think that's key, and that's the success of Kingsgate development. Look at the size of it and the scale of the development. You know, we've been fortunate that we've got a councillor, we've got an Ngosi, and a community that has supported the project and bought into the idea of the project. And for us, it's more than just having good buyers that are bringing together, but at least we've got a community that's working it. We're creating the skills, we're creating employment.
Yeah.
This is over a 3-year period.
Yeah.
So you can imagine the job creation that's created in the economy, which is, we've seen a lot of unemployment bloodbath at the moment. So we're very excited to contribute positively to the economy and to the employment level, especially in around this community.
Yeah, very much. And of course, long term, I mean, the job creation for decades to come is fantastic.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Michael, some people are still a little bit unsure about the future of South Africa. I mean, we read a lot of negative press. But from our perspective, since President Ramaphosa was sworn into office, there seems to be a really positive vibe happening in the country. It's almost a new dawn, a new era, just to coin the phrase. How do you think that's going to, do you agree with that first of all, and how do you think that's going to maybe feed through to the property market?
Absolutely. I think for us, obviously, the new dawn is what the country needed. It's what the people needed.
Yeah.
You know, and without any doubt, it has shown a good outlook already.
Yes.
You know, we got that positive spin from investors.
Absolutely.
You know, really looking into South Africa.
Yeah.
And for us, it's about now having the political will in terms of creating jobs, growing the economy. Okay. And obviously, for us, it's important that this spills over to the property side.
Yeah.
Because then we get the benefits. So it's a collective effort.
It is.
You know, and for us, starting from the top in terms of having political will,
you're
starting to see the benefits. And we're here for the long haul, properties for the long haul.
Absolutely.
You know,
it's a cornerstone of our society.
Absolutely. You know, and we've started at the lowest end of where we are in terms of the economy. You know, and now imagine when the turnaround does come. You know, so for us, we're excited that, you know, that the president that we have looks at the bigger picture, and the president that's leading us obviously assist in terms of making sure the economy does grow.
Yes.
And for us, that's important as business people.
It really and truly is. Marco, as a highly successful businessman and someone who's achieved so much, what advice would you have to perhaps younger people think of entering the property market to own or actually to make it their career? Would you advise them that's a good place to be?
Absolutely, Patrick. For us, I think, for me personally, I've given a lot of public speeches, motivation to youngsters.
Yes.
And also for me, it always starts with education. Mm. You know, you've got to get the education system right, go to university, get your degree, you know. And obviously property is a long-term game. And there's barriers to entry in terms of investment that you've got to bring in, unfortunately.
Yeah.
But you know, you've got to learn from the bottom.
Absolutely.
Start from the bottom. It's about learning and listening.
Yeah.
That's my motto in terms of property. You've got to be patient.
Yeah.
And obviously for any youngster, you know, property is an opportunity for you.
Really,
and go to school and start at education level.
Yeah. Absolutely. And of course, once you get your foot in the door, you can slowly start to climb that ladder.
Absolutely. Mm. And that's exactly where I started. You know, I went to University of Natal.
Yeah.
I studied my BSc Construction Management, and that was like for 4 years. And then I went into private practice.
Yeah.
And from there, you know, I grew into a bigger space within the property environment.
Fantastic. Marco, I know you've obviously worked with a lot of teams on all your projects. We at Century 21 have been so honored to really work with your professional team. I just wanted to ask you, what actually got you involved with us as a Century 21 brand? Why did you choose us for Kingsgate?
Patrick, it's so simple. You guys are a global player, you're a global brand. Mm. You've proven by the sales that you've done so far for us. So for us, it just didn't make any sense to go with anyone else. So for us, we're really satisfied. And obviously, with the marketing and obviously with the Tour de France, which I actually watched on TV.
You love it.
I love it.
And the South African one, they were in people on the stage the other day.
Exactly. So for us, we're very excited. And obviously, we're looking forward to what the Century 21 on all our developments. I can assure you.
Oh, that's fantastic. Well, Marco, thank you very much.
Thank you
so much for joining us.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.